I'm Eric Coyle. I often get questions about how to access workforce and jobs data. One of my favorite data tools to use is OnTheMap, available at census.gov. It allows you to visualize where workers live and where they work from many areas in the country. Let me introduce you to OnTheMap.
There are two ways to get to the OnTheMap tool from the census.gov homepage. You can either select through the Explore Data tab by then clicking on Data Tools and Apps. From there, you can go to the next page, which will take you to the next list of data tools, and there you'll find the link to OnTheMap. The other way is to select through the Browse by Topic tab, and you would choose Employment. And there you simply scroll down under the data heading, and you will find OnTheMap. Once in the OnTheMap tool, you'll be able to quickly begin your area profile analysis by simply typing in the geography of choice within the search bar. You can also narrow that search by simply selecting any of these geographies within this drop-down menu. Additionally, you have a base map that allows for adding various labels, points, outlines, and fills within the selected layers. The Selections tab will allow you to visualize the boundaries of the area you selected. There are also drawing tools and other layers that can be added, along with a buffer that you can add to your selection to create your own unique geographies. And lastly, there is the ability to import your own geography. So here in the Start tab, I'll go ahead and type in Dallas. And if I leave the default to Search All Names and click Search, I'm going to see a very long list of geographies related to the word Dallas. However, if I want to narrow that search, I simply select a term like places for cities and towns, click Search again, and now my list is much smaller. From here, I can go ahead and select Dallas City, Texas, which will now be zoomed into on the map. To see what that selection looks like outlined, I simply click on the Selection tab, which will now give me an outline of my geographic area. To perform an analysis, all I have to do is click on this red kite symbol. And there I can go ahead and perform my analysis. The default of this analysis will allow you to analyze where workers work or where workers live. The default analysis type is the area profile for all workers, but you can also look at other variables within age groups, income groups, as well as two specific industries. If you'd like to look at multiple years and see the change over time, you would go ahead and select multiple years.
Keep in mind, new data is added every year.
You can also go beyond the default of private primary jobs and select all jobs. To get definitions of all these different types of selections, you simply need to hover over the question mark of each one. And then click Go. And there you have it. We now have a results tab giving us a work area profile analysis, a title that we can edit if we'd like to, along with a subtitle. The display settings will give us the total characteristic filter for the year. We can also change the color. We can remove the thermal overlay and of course bring it back. And the same goes for the point overlay. You can identify these point overlays. You can zoom to the selection. You can clear the overlays and you can animate them as well. You also have the ability to download and print a detailed report, export geography, and print a chart and map. The legend will show you what each shade of the thermal overlay represents from the lightest to the darkest, as well as giving you the number of jobs for the smallest point to the largest. The analysis settings will tell you exactly what you've selected in your area profile analysis. To the right, you'll notice we have a chart that we can switch from bar to pie by using the drop-down menu. You also have the total jobs provided for that particular year selected, as well as the share. You can look at worker age, earnings, NAICS industry sector, worker race, ethnicity, worker educational attainment, and worker sex. To visualize any of these variables on the map, simply click on them. For example, I'll select age 29 or younger. And now the map will show me only those jobs that fall into the variable of age 29 or younger. If I want to reset that to show all jobs representing every single criteria, I simply click on Reset Table. At the top of your map, you'll notice that you have a save feature to allow you to return to this particular search. You can also load a previously saved search criteria. You can use the zoom features to allow you to zoom all the way down to the street level or zoom all the way back out to see the full picture of the US. And that's how easy it is to create an area profile analysis.
I hope you find OnTheMap useful. To learn how to create an area comparison analysis of your labor market, check out our next OnTheMap data gem at census.gov/academy. And don't forget to subscribe.